The family of Jeff Bettinger speaks out tonight after his chase, crash, and capture. His family says they were also scared for their lives while he was on the run. Phil Sanchez starts our team coverage off tonight from Indianapolis.
I'm Sharon Bettinger. I'm Jeff's stepmother.
And I am Paige Miller, and I am Jeff Bettinger's stepsister.
And Sharon and Paige now left to answer all the questions.
It's just such a tragedy on so many levels.
And in the middle of it all, 7-year-old Zane. Bettinger took the boy after allegedly killing his 22-year-old stepson.
He shot Brandon 3 times and then told Kim she needed to prepare her will. He was going to kill her next, and then he shot Brandon 4 more times.
Bettinger drove to Carmel, where he dropped Zane off at a friend's house. The family says they thought he was coming for them next. Sharon, married to Jeff's father for more than 30 years, says Bettinger has been out of work for more than a year, depressed and in the process of filing for bankruptcy, and angry at his family for not helping him buy a new car.
We knew he was upset with us because his dad had told him we wouldn't buy him that car, and he told him that that was, our decision, not just his.
You know, when someone has lost everything and they've got nothing else to lose, that's a really dangerous emotional position to be in.
Dangerous no more. Bettinger is now in jail.
The other thing is we have spoken with Jeff today.
A phone conversation from that jail cell in Ohio.
I said, Jeff, I'm so happy to hear your voice and know you're safe. He said, I wish I was dead. I said, I know you do, but God's not through with you. And we're going to get through this.
Again, that was Phil Sanchez reporting. Now, Bettinger will be arraigned on Monday. He's currently in the Miami County Jail. His family says he told them that he plans on pleading guilty. However, the family hopes the abduction charges will be dropped.